Pythagoras and his followers realized that musical intervals, pairs of notes at different frequencies, have to do with simple fractions or ratios. Dividing the length of a string or a pipe in half doubles its frequency. The wave has half as far to travel, so it vibrates twice as fast. This raises the note by an octave. A high C beats twice as fast as a middle C in a 2-to-1 ratio. When a soprano sings along with a tenor, she's singing an octave above him, vibrating the air twice as fast. Our symphony stage crew is bringing out the symphony's custom-made PVC tubaphone with principal percussionist Dave Tolan. A tube of 4-inch wide PVC tubing, approximately 10 feet long, sounds a low A. A pipe of the same width but half as long sounds an A an octave higher. Played together, we can hear the notes harmonize an octave apart.
In music, a ratio of 3-to-2 is called a fifth, like the interval between C and G, giving us the primal interval at the beginning of Also Sprach Zarathustra. A 4-3 ratio is called a fourth, like between C and F. 5-4 and 6-5 ratios are major and minor thirds, and so on. These multiples form the scales and chords used throughout the world. When we hear a C major chord, we are hearing the fourth, fifth, and sixth multiples, or harmonics, of the C 2 octaves below it.
Ancient music used these harmonies in a way that still rings true today. The Hurrian hymn is more than 3,000 years old. We're not quite sure, but we think it sounded something like this. And almost 1,000 years ago, in 1100 AD, Hildegard von Bingen used the same intervals to convey her feelings of sacredness and revelation.
Here to sing the von Bingen is the Santa Fe Women's Ensemble with Linda Rainey directing.